Bleach is a modern day influence, standing alongside the big three, One Piece and Naruto. It is surprising to many that in this current era of Shonen Jump, Bleach is the most apparent when it comes to its influence and reference. More notably, in Demon Slayer and Jujutsu Kaisen. And everybody knows Jujutsu Kaisen has become a behemoth of a series, arguably one of the most talked about of this decade. From its likeable characters, easy to digest story and fan service that is Gojo. A man, do women and men love Gojo, and some for different reasons. It seems that Jujutsu Kaisen fully embraced what it meant to meet the criteria that is Shonen Jump. Which is why, as the recording of this video, Jujutsu Kaisen has concluded its manga run with an impressive 271 chapters, and will undoubtedly leave a huge online discourse absence. So I thought it would be a good opportunity to show some love to Jujutsu Kaisen, as it has to my favourite series, by talking about some of the cool Easter eggs and references throughout its Shonen Jump tenure. But first, a message from our sponsor. With the Jujutsu Kaisen manga completed, everyone feels depressed. And look, I get it, but guess what? I'm here to save you. Because in the Jujutsu Kaisen Festival, they announced its first officially licensed mobile game, Jujutsu Kaisen Phantom Parade. You can finally become a sorcerer and use curse techniques to exercise curses. This game really captures the anime's vibes, retelling the story with all new voice acting whilst experiencing the perspectives of different characters. Like, come on, we read the manga, we watch the anime, and we all say we want to see much more of such and such characters. You will of course relive the peak moments of the anime, like the Goodwill arc, and participate in intense battles. In Japan, this game is a huge hit. But now, Bilibili Game is taking it global by the year end. Pre-registrations are now open and have exceeded a huge 3 million. Additionally, once global pre-registrations reach 10 million, all players will receive a redrawable SSR character guaranteed gacha ticket along with cubes worth 25 draws. You can also invite friends to form your own Phantom Parade team. The more friends you invite to play, the more rewards you'll receive. So don't miss out, pre-register the game right now, and all information is in the description down below. So let's get back into the video, shall we? Jujutsu Kaisen's author Gege Akutami throughout the years has always been honest about his love for Taito Kubo and the influence of his series. As stated by the man Gege himself in a special talk with Kubo himself, telling him that he was the reason he became what he is. Which I guess brings us to our first major influence, that is Aoi Todo. In a television interview, Gege spoke about his influences, one notably being Aoi Todo, taking great inspiration from the badass Kenpachi Zaraki. Gege also makes this statement from a Jujutsu Kaisen fan book that Aoi Todo, for example, takes up the brutality and straightforwardness of Kenpachi Zaraki from Bleach. And for anyone familiar with both series would absolutely agree with this. While both characters are both extremely different in personality, Todo can be a bit goofy at times while Kenpachi is very serious. But it is in fact apparent that both are fundamentally dangerous characters. With the brutality and straightforward character that Gege emphasizes, there is no explanation needed. Oh, he's the bad guy? Okay, let's kick his ass. Type of feeling. These are characters that when you look at them, you know from design that they're going to be pretty badass and have a big impact. But Gege just doesn't stop at characters. There are two very heavily referenced drawings from JJK that are straight homages to Bleach, with one being Volume 14, being Sukuna reaching out his hand, much like Grimmjow does from Volume 24. Which in my opinion is funny, as Grimmjow and Sukuna have extremely similar personalities in just being crazy, unhinged and purely instinctual. One other scene is Geto throwing an attack towards Yuji, and the execution is extremely similar, even down to the pose of Ichigo and Byakuya when he hits Ichigo with a Zenbon Sakura. They both get hit in the same fashion and even pose after the attack in the same fashion. It would be very confident to say that this is a huge nod towards Bleach. But let's talk about things that are maybe a little bit more headcanon-y per se. And what I mean by this are scenes and moments that have extreme familiarity but without evidence. With the last concept being a bit of a hot take, so be sure to stay tuned. So based from strongest to weakest, let's start off with the Gojo Barrier. During the Goodwill Arc, or as people also call it, the Kyoto Arc, where the two high schools fight in an event, Geto Suguru makes a barrier for his invasion of the Jujutsu students. However, this barrier is weak because of the condition it holds. The condition is to keep Gojo Satoru out from interfering, and only him alone. Not only does this seem extremely familiar to the Senkaimon and Urahara, but the way it is also demonstrated also shows a very strong resemblance. But from here on out, however, gets a little bit more assumption based. As you have seen, such as Gojo getting his arm sliced off, which seems very reminiscent of Basby versus Hushworld. Now, getting your hand or arm removed isn't new in shonen or in fiction. Some might even say this has a relation from Hunter x Hunter contextually, but when you bleed the images together, you can't help but notice that, you know, it's almost exactly the same. So I thought that this may be a pretty cool homage too. In terms of inspiration, I kind of contemplated this one as it's not really canon to the manga. Even for animation stuff, I thought that this scene of Yuji and Todo running away from Mahito through the Shibuya subway system was pretty cool, not to mention, as it has a nice resemblance to Ichigo and Rukia running through the Dangai. You know, the tunnel where it has the cleaner. Now, we don't know if Gege has involvement with anime extensions, but it's a nice nod anyway if it is the case. So, now let's get into my hot take, so to say. And it may even ruffle a few feathers. Now, while there isn't any evidence of this, it seems that there is a lot of discourse online comparing domain expansions to Bankai. Now, not every Bankai has its own area of effect, so to say, but a lot do, such as Tozen's Bankai or Byakuya's. Could domain expansions be influenced by this mechanic? I would suggest, because literally why not? I think the difficulty is proving this influence, but we know that Gege has a lot of Bleach influence in general, so it's plausible. But it really came at a bit of a particular center of discussion, or should I say resurfaced, when Senjimaru used her Bankai in Bleach Anime Core 2, and new fans made the domain expansion reference. But it was even more accelerated and fueled when Ichibei released his mausoleum, as it was very strikingly similar to Sukuna's malevolent shrine. It is difficult to have this discussion as it is Japan, and Japan does have heavy influence in general with Shintoism and shrines in general, especially when you have this series surrounding in Japan. It would in fact be very shocking if temples or shrines weren't used as a factor of some sorts. But at the same time, Bleach could have had a great reference point on how to go about using it or how it would look in a manga setting. But I suppose I'll leave that question off to you in the comment section down below. Does domain expansion get its inspiration from Bankai? And if so, why? Tell me in the comment section down below. Regardless of what I think Jujutsu Kaisen has made such a huge impact, not only on the industry, but for also a new wave of anime and manga fans for the future to come worldwide. Seeing how my favourite manga and author have influenced the future going forward, I wanted to pay my own respects to such an awesome series that was showing love for where it essentially came from. But Gege, I will never forgive you for the lack of Miwa. Best girl needs her screen time, man, and you fumbled that. It is what it is, I suppose. But again, I want to say thank you to this video sponsor, Bilibili and Jujutsu Kaisen's Phantom Parade. Please go check it out, and please go show some love and support. But with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. Please hit that like and subscribe on your way out. And as always, people, peace out.